So the majority, like I said, of what we're doing is in the calculator. So let's just, before we get started, let's just get the settings in our calculator fixed. So everybody go to your calculator. Follow me through the settings. Okay, first of all, because of statistics, our calculators tend to be messed up. So if you need to reset your calculator, you'll hit second, plus sign, and then go to number 7, which says reset, all RAM. And then, yes, I want to reset. Because then it's like a fresh, brand new calculator. It's good to know that anyways, how to do that. So we hopefully have all reset our calculator so it's nice and fresh. So now we're going to go to our mode. We've got to change the mode on our calculator because we're going to be graphing polar equations. So notice right now it's in radian mode. That's fine. But to me, degree mode is going to be the best because looking at degree measures is a lot easier. Like 30 degrees is a lot easier than that 0.95. Does that make kind of sense? So we're going to do degree mode. So when we graph, we'd rather, degrees will be easier to think about, I would say. So hit degree. Then down here it says function. We're going to go to polar. We're doing polar equation, polar graphs today. So hit enter. Degree and polar. Now let's get out of here. So hit second, quit. And then we're going to go to our window. And right now, notice it's in radians. See how it says the degree minimum. We do want it to be 0 degrees, our minimum degree, but right now it's 6.28, which is 2 pi, isn't it? That's radian. So let's just scroll down and go 360 so that we're just kind of staying consistent. And then it says theta step. I'm just going to make it 1 degree measure. The tick mark's in 1 degrees, I guess. It's not life or death. And then that's it. So now what we're going to hit again, so now we can get out of there. And now the next thing we're going to change is we don't want there to be 360 XY points we graph. Do you agree with me? So we're going to change the way our XY chart is set up. We're going to go in groups of 30 degrees so that we're only graphing so many points. So hit second window. So that's table set. Second window. And then it says, where do you want it to, your table to start? Let's start at 0 degrees. And then it says, what's the change you want your table to go in? Like that triangle says delta table. That means the change of your table. Let's do 30 degrees. You could do less than that, but to me, 30 is what increments we go around the unit circle on, so that's why I picked 30. Make sense? Okay, now hit quit. All right, so let's go to our calculator's ready to go for when we need it to be ready. Okay, so this one's going to be easiest graphed by hand. So this says graph the polar equation. It says radius equal to 3. Doesn't that just mean we have a circle with radius 3? So you'd go to the center here at 0, 0, and we'd go out 1, 2, 3 units, and we would draw in our circle. Now notice this is not drawn as an XY chart. It's drawn in my polar system, but it's the same thing as an XY chart, correct? We learned that last time? Okay, so there's your circle, radius 3. Pretty straightforward. That's it. Graph. Done. We've done that. Okay, let's do this one. This says you have a theta equal to pi thirds. Now what does that mean? Well, that means we have a line at pi thirds, doesn't it? Because you go to pi thirds, our theta of pi thirds, there it is, and it didn't say anything about a certain radius. So it's all the radiuses. So then we have this line. Now, last time we learned how to put that into y equals mx plus b form. That's not what we're asked to do today. We're asked to just graph. So we have the easiest thing today. Done. All good? Okay, next one. Okay, before we graph our polar equations, I'm going to point out a couple few things with symmetry. So there will always be symmetry when it comes to graphing polar equations, always. The question is just what is it symmetric over? So it will be symmetric over one of the three things. So it's either going to be symmetric over the pi halves line. Now, the reason they call it pi halves instead of the y-axis is because we're graphing in polar form. So remember the polar of the the way to say the y-axis in polar form is to say over pi halves. Does that make sense? But I don't care how you say it. So I'm going to probably say throughout the lesson, this is symmetric over the y-axis, because that's the same thing as the pi halves axis. Then there is symmetry over the polar axis. Now, once again, the polar axis just means the x-axis here. So symmetry across the x-axis or polar axis. And then there's also going to be possibility for symmetry over the pole. Now, the pole is just the y equals x axis or the origin. So we are going to have symmetry over one of the three. Now, how do we know? Well, this is how we test it out. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our equation, and our equation will be a polar equation, so there will be r's and thetas in our equation. So what we're going to do with our r and our theta is we're going to replace it with this, this, and this. So I would just start here, replace it with negative r, negative theta. So if you put in negative r, negative theta, and then you use math to simplify it down, and it comes out to be the exact same as the original, r theta, then it has symmetry over the y-axis. So if we go and plug in, instead of plugging in negative r, negative theta, if we plug in still positive r, but just negative theta, we do math, simplify it down, and it comes out to be the original r theta. If that's the case, now notice they all come out to be the original. It's just which one comes out to be the original. So if that happens here, then it would have symmetry over the x-axis. And then our final one is if we take and plug in negative r positive theta, and it simplifies down to be the original r theta, then it has symmetry about the origin. Now there is a possibility for it to have symmetry over two things or both. And it doesn't matter, you only have to show one. You know what I mean? Once you know symmetry of one of them, you're able to draw the rest of the graph. Now, the reason we care about symmetry a lot of times, you guys, is because we don't want to have to plot so many dang points. If you had this side of the graph, and by plotting points, and you knew it had symmetry over the y-axis, then it would be okay to just draw in the other side, because you're able to prove that it has symmetry. Does that make sense? So then, once again, let's say we had the top half of the graph, but we knew it had symmetry over the x-axis. It would be then okay and appropriate to just draw in the other half without having to plot so dang many points. And then same here. If you had this half of the graph drawn and you knew it had symmetry over the origin, now once again, then you could just draw in the other half. So we'll be doing graph sketches today. So a lot of times when graphing, that's kind of the first thing you check. But you're going to see that, honestly, we're going to use a lot of our calculator. So we'll be able to visually see the symmetry kind of. Not kind of, we will be able to. Okay, do you guys need more time to write any of this down before I move on to the next slide? Because if so, I'm fine with waiting. I just am not sure if you need more time or not. All good then? Okay. All right, so let's get to it. My first example, we're going to do completely by hand. Now, everybody was asking me, well, the rest of the lesson, the first two examples we're going to do by hand, and then the rest we're just going to plug into our calculator. So I had everybody ask me, so will I have to do them by hand? Yes, it is a possibility. However, you will also have your calculator as an aid. Does that make sense? So if we did require you to do one by hand, it's going to be a very basic one like the following. The really, really advanced ones that we won't ask you to do by hand. So let's see how this would work, everybody. So we're going to graph r is equal to 3 sine of theta. So the first thing I'm going to do is see what does this have symmetry over? So I'm going to take my equation, I'm going to go down here, we know there were three possibilities. So let's plug in negative r, negative theta. So that would be negative r is equal to 3 sine of negative theta. Now we've got to simplify that. You guys see how I just replaced r and theta with negative r, negative theta? Now you have to remember that sine and tangent are considered odd functions. Therefore, if you have a negative inside, you can pull it to the outside of the function. Cosine's even, so if we have a negative on the inside, it just becomes positive. Just a reminder. So we have negative r is equal to, we're going to pull out the negative since sine is odd. So then we have negative 3 sine of theta. So now to divide both sides by negative 1, so then we get r is equal to 3 sine of theta. Do you guys see how once we simplified it came out to be the exact same thing as the original? Therefore, we know we have symmetry over our y-axis. So now we can move on. We can just start graphing. Okay. So what we're going to do here is I'm just going to remind you how this graph looks on just an XY chart here. So just a reminder, we have 3 sine of theta. Our amplitude is 3. Agreed? Amplitude is 3, and then we have a period of 2 pi. Because look, 2 pi divided by b, b is 1, so our period is 2 pi. So look what I've done. Isn't the cycle for sine 0 max, 0 min, 0? So do you guys see how I went 0, then up to 3 max, then 0, then min, down to negative 3, 0? Okay, so I have graphed it on an XY chart here, and then as you can see, our increments here are split up as 0, here's pi-halves, pi, 3 pi-halves, 2 pi. Okay, sweet. So let's go ahead, and we're going to now make a theta r chart, or r theta chart, same thing, and we're going to see what points we can plot on our polar form here. All right, so let's see what zero is. Let's plug in zero to this equation. Now, you can also use this. At zero, if we plug in zero, what's the sign at zero at? Zero, which makes sense. Look at your unit circle. If the sign at zero is our y value, so sine of zero is zero. Zero times three is zero. Okay, moving on. Now, notice I have pi 6 and pi thirds, but normally we jump past those and just go to here, right? Normally we go 0, pi halves, pi, 3 pi halves, 2 pi. I'm going to come back to these two points. Now, could I graph as many points as I wanted? So you'll see why I'm doing that. Just the first time is to give you a visual of what's going on. So let's actually go to pi halves. At pi halves, we're at 3, aren't we, everyone? Which makes sense. Look, at pi halves, we're at 1. 1 times 3 is 3. So you guys see I'm literally just plugging it in. Pi, we're at 0, aren't we? Back down to 0. At 3 pi halves, we're at, and then at 2 pi, we're at 0 again, aren't we? Which makes sense. Look, 0, max 0, min 0. That's usually how we did our x, y charts. Okay, cool. Now, I just want to have us have a few couple points on this section. Now, look, from here to pi halves, I want to have a couple more points. Now, don't we know it starts at 0 and it's getting larger slowly until we get to 3? Yeah. So let's plug in pi 6 and calculate. So everybody look. Right here's pi 6. Sine is 1 half. So 3 times a half is? Good. So let's just do decimals. 1.5. Good. Now let's go to pi thirds, everyone. Right here is pi thirds. The y value is root 3 over 2. So sine at pi thirds is root 3 over 2. Root 3 over 2 times 3 is about 2.6-ish, everyone. So do you guys see how it started at 0, went up to 1.5, 2.6, up to 3, which makes sense. Now, I didn't plot more points in between here, but we know there are more. Okay, let's work around. Let's now start putting that on our polar grid here. Now, remember, the first thing you do is go to theta, then you go out r radiuses. So, I wanted to go back. One more thing before we start graphing this. Because I should have reviewed with you, this is always where people have a hard time. They don't have a hard time with anything but this. If I said to you, graph the point 3 pi thirds, how do you graph that? I'm going to do it in red. What do? You go to pi thirds, then you go out 3 units. Okay, good. Now, what if I change it to negative 3 pi thirds? How does that work? Yep, you'll go to pi thirds, but then you go back 1, 2, 3 units. So that just means walk backwards. Remember that? Okay, cool. Now, that was all I wanted to read. Okay, here we go. So let's graph this point. Now, here we go in order. Starting at 0, we're at 0. Agreed? Mm-hmm. Now we're going out to pi 6 next, which is right here. And we're going out 1.5 radiuses. So about right there. Now I'm connecting here. So it's kind of making this curve, just like it's making a curve here. You guys see? Mm-hmm. All right, let's keep going. So I've graphed this point and this point. Now we're going to pi thirds out 2.6 radiuses. So pi thirds out 2.6. So we're curving. And then we're going out to pi halves, which is right here, up 1, 2, 3 units. So do you guys see how it's just curving around? And then we're at pi to 0. So now everybody understand. Pi to 0 is right here, this section. Now, pi 0 is back to right here, back to this pink dot, isn't it? Do you think it goes straight down? No, doesn't it curve? We just don't have all the points listed. Does that make sense like I did in that first section? So it's going to curve the same. Now, couldn't we just stop here and know, since it has symmetry over the y-axis, isn't this my y-axis? Mm-hmm. It should be symmetry over the y-axis, so now I could just draw a rough sketch as accurate as possible. Have symmetry. And we're done. Now, let's keep graphing. So we just graphed that point. Now, watch what happens here. Go to 3 pi halves, which is right here, everyone, and then it says go back 3 units. So back 1, 2, 3. You guys see how it's just right back on top of itself. And then we're at 2 pi 0. So now after this, all the points are just right back on top of the points that are already there. So it just created like a circle. I didn't draw that very accurate, but once again, rough sketches. Okay. Awesome. Any questions on that? Pretty easy, right? Okay, let's do another one by hand. Oh, but for kicks and giggles, let's now type that into our calculator and see if it looks right. So go to y equals, and then type in 3, then sine, and then right here where this little x, t, theta button is, just hit theta. X, T, theta right here. And then hit graph. And look at that. Yeah, you should have, your mode needs to be changed somehow. Do you need to borrow a calculator today? Because you can. Did everybody get their circle? It's just our window's a little squishy, but. Now look what we could also do. Let's see if our XY points match up. So couldn't we go second table and now we have our table of values? Did 0, 0 match up with our points? How about, now remember, what is pi 6? Isn't that 30 degrees? Did our 30 degrees match up, 1.5? You guys see how it's just the same thing? We just did it all by hand. Okay, cool. Sweet. Okay, let's do one more by hand. The rest of the, then after that, we'll just use our calculator. All right, let's do r is equal to 3 cosine theta. Now first, once again, because on the test they might ask you, show me what axis this equation is symmetric over. And you would have to use the math to do it. So if we plug in negative r negative theta, guys, that would be, just watch, this one's not it. So I'll just show you how it wouldn't work. You'd say negative r is equal to 3 cosine of negative theta. Now, cosine of negative theta is just cosine of theta since it's even. So then we have negative r is equal to 3 cosine of theta. And you guys see how it doesn't come out to be the original. So you'd say, nope, not symmetry over y. Now let's try r negative theta. So we have r is equal to 3 cosine of negative theta, which we get r equals 3 cosine of theta, since cosine's even. So yep, that came out to be the exact same as the original, therefore there is symmetry over the x-axis. All right, so let's look at graphing cosine. Just a reminder, our amplitude is 3, our period is 2 pi. So look, I went up 3, down 3 units, and then the cycle for cosine, max 0, min 0, max. So that's why max 0, min 0, max looks like this, over 2 pi. Right, this is cosine, 3 cosine of theta on an XY chart. Okay, let's do it on this. So we have 0, we're at 3, aren't we? Max, shouldn't we go to pi house next? 0, min, 0, max, isn't that how that cosine works? And then I'm plotting 2 extra points in between in this first interval. Now we know it's getting smaller, do you guys see? So if we type in pi 6, so we go to pi 6, the cosine of pi 6 is root 3 over 2. Root 3 over 2 times 3 is about 2.6. Now we'll go to root 3. The cosine of root 3 is a half, so 3 times a half is 1.5. So now let's look at graphing that by hand. So this says go to 0 degrees and out 3 units. 1, 2, 3. Check. Go up to pi 6 and then out 2.6 units. Out 1, 2.6. Now I'm connecting on the curve here. And then I'm going up pi thirds and then up 1.5 units. Then I'm going over pi halves of 0. So it's right there, so connecting. Now what can I do? Since I know it's symmetric over the x-axis, can't I just make the bottom half now? Trying to make it as symmetric as possible. Pretty dang good. All right. Now look, if you go to pi, that would be right here, and then don't we go back 1, 2, 3 units? Do you see how it's just on top of each other again after that? Okay, cool. You guys are doing great. Okay, cool. Now let's get to the really cool graphs. These are the different types of graphs you will see. You're going to write these down super quickly. Yes, it might be useful to have this information, so write them down quickly. So circles are created when you have polar equations that look like this form. We just saw two examples of this. If you were ever asked to graph one by hand with no calculator, it would just be a super basic one with a circle, I would say. Otherwise, you'd be able to use your calculator. So if r is equal to a sine of theta, r is equal to a cosine of theta will create these circles with symmetry depending on the problem. Now, there's these graphs, polar graphs called lemniscates, I can't say it. Lemniscates. I don't know. So, I swear I remember, it kind of sounds like leprechauns, lemon scots, lemon scats. I don't know. Okay. Anyways, it will have your equation. Your polar equation will have this form. There'll be an r squared and then your a squared, and then it'll be cosine of 2 theta. So there'll be r squared, a squared, and then there'll be a 2 in front of your theta. Same here. R squared, a squared, sine of 2 theta. It'll create these, like, infinity signs. Those are lemon skates. Can I go to the next slide? Not yet. Okay, now there are these types of polar graphs you will see. They'll have the form R is equal to A plus or minus, just depending on the problem, B sine theta. R is equal to A plus or minus. It'll just depend on the problem. It could be plus, it could be minus, B cosine theta. So what will happen are, these are called lemmicons, and there's different kind of lemmicons. I think it's actually lemmicons. Maybe that's the one I thought sounded like leprechaun. Lemmicon. Yeah, okay. That makes more sense than the last one. So there's this inner loop that can be created, and that would be if your A divided by B is less than 1. So, like, if you take A and divide it by B and it's less than 1, and I think this might be in absolute values, I'm pretty sure. I don't know why I didn't write absolute values. So if A divided by B is less than 1, it's going to create this inner loop. Now, that doesn't mean it's going to be up here necessarily. It could be an inner loop over on the side. Do you guys see what I'm saying? Depending on if it's symmetric where. Does that make sense? Because people were, like, seeing graphs like this, and then they're like, what happened, Miss Christensen? This has a loop down here. Same, it's fine. I just had you guys see what I'm saying. It just depends on the graph. There just is going to be an inside circle and a bigger circle around it. All right, then there's what's called a cardioid, because apparently that looks like a heart. Cardiothoracic surgeon does heart surgery. So if A divided by B is equal to 1, it'll have this, it'll be at 0, and then create this, like, heart-looking thing, a cardioid. Now, dimpled happens when, I call it a dimpled butt. I don't know why. It's just fun and funny. So a dimpled butt here. So it doesn't touch down at 0. So it's like, it still looks kind of like a cardioid. It's just, it's not all the way to 0. And that's if your A divided by B is between 1 and 2. And then convex graphs will happen if A divided by B is greater than or equal to 2. It's going to be like an oval, kind of an ellipse looking thing. Now, we're going to have our calculator when graphing these, so it's just kind of to make, you can kind of use this information to check to make sure when you graph it on your paper that it looks right. Like, oh, this should look like a cardioid, therefore it should start at 0 and go out because A divided by B is 1. While you're still writing that down, understand, right, we can turn these different ways. For example, this cardioid could have looked like like that. You guys see how I'm just putting it on a different side? Same thing though. Started at 0 and went out, creating a heart looking thing. Alright. Okay, and the last are the flower graphs. We like those. These are the cool ones, I think. So these are called rose curves. So polar graphs that have the form R is equal to A sine of N theta, R is equal to A cosine of N theta will create rose curves. And if the N, right here, the inside next to theta, if it's even, then there will be twice as many petals, 2N petals, twice as many if it's even. Now if N is odd, an odd number, it will be that many petals, N petals. So if it's odd, it'll be that many petals. If it's even, double it. So right here we have R is equal to A sine of 2 theta, for example. That would create a graph with 4 petals. You guys see how 2 is even? Times by 2, it would be 4 petals. So right here we have R is equal to A cosine of 4 theta. Now notice there would be how many petals here? 8 petals, because 4 is even, so times it by 2. Now how far out, how, like, it makes sense, guys, let's think about this. What would A be, like, how far out would I be, depending on what A is? Like, for, let's say I put a 10 here, how far out would I be? 10, isn't our amplitude 10 at that point? So it makes sense that if we were to make an XY chart, the max would be a 10. Do you guys see how that makes sense? Okay. So your amplitude is how far out you'll go. And then right here, so once again, notice this is A cosine of 3 theta, therefore there are 3 petals. 5 theta, 5 petals, and yada, yada, yada. And once again, the amplitude is the maximum how far out you'd be. Now, these all are symmetric. I can't draw perfectly. That's why they don't look like it. They will be, though. The petals will all be nice and pretty. So I don't know if you've ever seen, there's like a math shirt, like a math shirt that like says you, like it has the math equation that creates, like it's supposed to be for lovebirds that are in math. I've never been in love with a math person, so I don't send them equations with parts, but there are equations with hearts. So, you know, now that we've learned this, you'll know how to make a heart. All right. Here we go. So now we'll just use our calculator. I want you to type in 4 sine of 3 theta. So go to your graph. 4 sine of 3 theta. Now we just learned that that looks like a rose. Won't that be a rose one? With 3 petals? Because it's n is odd. Sorry. So now you have your rose petals. Now, you can't do really, you've got to be a little bit more accurate when you get to your chart here. So hit second table. Now, what I want you to do is tell me at what degrees we're at what. So everybody, just maybe start at, 0 degrees. We're at 30 degrees. 60, 90. And that's probably good enough. Will you agree? Because then we know how it looks. So we're going 0, 0. That's where you start. Then we're going, the next one is up to 30 degrees out 4 units. So look, here's 30 degrees out 1, 2, 3, 4. So then isn't it a curve? Okay, then we're going out 60 out 4. Oh, 60 zero. Back to 0. So 60 right here, we're back to 0. So that would be connecting back to 0 like that. Then at 90 right here, we're at negative 4. Doesn't that mean just walk backwards? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that was curving around like this. Then at 120 right here, we're back at 0. So boom, that would bring us back to 0. Then at 150, we're at 150 right here. We're out 1, 2, 3, 4 units. So we were going out and then back, right? And that's what the graph looks like. It is cute, huh? And we're done. That's as accurate as you'd need to be. That's as much work as you would need to show. So you'll be using your calculator for the majority. Okay, so type into your, oopsies. Go away, go away. Go away, okay. Go type in this. This is my last example of the day. 3 minus 2 sine theta. Wait, was that what it was? Yeah. Graph. What's it creating? Is it really an oval, or is it a cardioid, or is it a dimpled butt, or is it a, what is it? We got to be accurate. It's dimpled. Now, how do you know that? Well, look back to your equation. What's 3 divided, wasn't it A divided by B that we look at? Go look back to what you wrote down. A divided by B, so what would that be? 3 divided by 2, right? So 1.5, what does that tell us it is? So it's dimpled. Okay, sweet. Now let's go to our theta R, hit second table of values, and let's just do, so 0 degrees, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150, 180. Okay, start giving me the values. Okay. Same thing. Okay. For our graph, same thing, right? Okay. What is this one? Okay, let's see if that's enough. So we're going over 0 out 1, 2, 3, check mark. Over 30 out 1, 2. So we're coming in like this. Over 60 out 1 point, barely any. Then we're out 90 out 1. Okay. Then we're at 120 right here. And then out 1.3. Aren't we dimpling back out now? Do you guys see how it's going back out? Then out 150 out 2. So out 1, 2. Then we're at 180 out 3. Now, do I need to keep going? Yeah, probably. So give me another, maybe like 225. Two 10 is 4. So go to 210, and then we're out 1, 2, 3, 4 units. Okay, another one. 270 XY, same thing as R theta. We're out 5. Right here, we're out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then don't we know it's symmetric? So can't I just draw a sketch? All good? Okay, sweet. That's the end of the lesson. So finish up the pink worksheet. Even though it says you cannot use a calculator, you can use a calculator. So you would just make an R theta chart and go for it, just like I just did. So notice it dimpled and not a cardioid because it didn't touch down at 0. It just dimpled.